Lakers host here are still entered with the LEGO Nexo Knights Lance vs Lightning. So this is the box here. So you can see it's recommended for just 8-14 and this set 70359 comes with 3 figures and yeah one big figure of course, and you know you can see you got Grimrock, you got Gargoyle and also Lance, and you know this set comes with 2 powers. You got Forbidden power and also a Nexo power. So I got this at Toys R Us for 50% off, which is really nice. So yeah, you can see this is the top and the side. You can see you got really nice like battle scene, you know, that's cool. And on the other side is just the Nexo powers. And yeah, so on the back you can see it shows you all the features and that you can combine the bottom half of the robot horse into this the Lance battle suit, which is nice I guess, but yeah, it looks really weird. So yeah, but that's it for the box. So this is the instruction manual, and yeah, so this is the first page, so this is the final page, and you got the parts list for the set, which is cool. And yeah, the other page, and yeah, so this shows you that you can combine the Lance battle suit into the robot horse. And yeah, so this is the like the all the combining stuff, you know. And yeah, so This just shows you how to scan the Nexo power, all the battle suits, and what conditions you should be in, and you know this where you can scan the Nexo power, and also all the sets of the wave. So yeah, that's it for the instructions. So these are the extra pieces here. So you can see comes with these like touring pieces or something. I'm not sure what they are called, but you know you got these studs, and you know 2 of these studs, they are stud with a hole in it, and you know does have extra like cheese loaf pieces, this T-shaped piece, and you know lightsaber hilt, this piece which is cool. You got this this thing, this clip piece or whatever, this pyramid piece, and also this clear blue pyramid piece. So yeah, you know, you also got a towel too. So yeah, that's it for all of the extra pieces. So the first figure here is Lance. So you can see he has the Lance here, which is really long, and yeah, looks really nice. Just made out of a few pieces, but yeah. So you can see his Nexo power here is Cripple Crubble, which you know it's a new Nexo power exclusive for a set, of course. And yeah, you remove it and see, you got his really nice helmet here. You open it up, you can see you got his face right there. His like, you know, smiley face I guess, but yeah, his armor looks really nice. You got this orange piece right there, and you know you got his family symbol, and you know like the leg printing looks nice. You got orange printing, and yeah, let's just remove the armor first to see the printing. So yeah, that's the printing for torso. And yeah, so the back here, and see, you got some armor printing, you got the orange like lights, I'm not quite sure what it is, but yeah, so this is his alternate expression. So yeah, like that's really it for Lance. So the second figure here is the Stone Army Gargoyle. So let's take a look at the wings first, but you know, you can see he, like the mold for them are like really nice, and you know like you got this translucent blue part which is cool, and yeah, they're on this clip piece, and you know they have this armor which you know has studs on the back, kind of like the knight's armor. And yeah, so ENC, he has this helmet here, which is pretty common throughout all the Stone Army stuff. And you see, he got the, like, the evil smell, I guess. But, you know, the torso printing looks pretty good. You know, you got the stone and everything. You got lightning inside them. And, yeah, the leg printing looks good, too. And, yeah, removing the head and this armor, yeah. Let's take a look at this alternate expression, which is this. I'm not sure what kind of face this is, what kind of expression it is. Could be a sad face or a defeated face, but yeah, I don't know. So, you can see you got some stone right there with the blue light lightning. And yeah, so that's it. So the final figure here is a Grimrock, which is the built up figure, of course. So you can see he has both of these like staff with the lightning on top of them, and yeah, they are just clipped on his hands. So let's just remove it, and yeah, they are just pretty simple builds, and you know, looks very good, I guess, pretty long. And yeah, so the figure here, you can see the helmet piece is pretty cool. You got like the side extension part, which you know makes his like ears really long. And yeah, so you got the same face I believe as the gargoyle. So yeah, alternate expression is also the same. And yeah, so you got all these like pyramid, translucent blue pyramid pieces all throughout the figure. And yeah, so the torso part is printed, of course. It's definitely not sticker. And yeah, so his arms, they are all on the ball joint, which, you know, you can move around. So yeah, that's cool. And yeah, so you got his little toes here, which, you know, you can move them out, you know, to expose this clip piece, which you can clip on this staff piece. So yeah, but, you know, the so moving on to the leg here, you can see this part here is the sticker part for this figure. And you know, it's pretty stable, I guess. Yeah, the shape here looks a little bit weird, but you know, it's pretty cool. So of course it's on ball joint. And yeah, so you know, you got this pyramid piece right here. And yeah, so like that's really it for Grimrock. So yeah, so this is Lance's robot horse. So let's start with the legs first. So they are all on ball joints, of course. And you know, the front one, each of them has a clip to clip onto the shield. And yeah, let's just do that right now. And you know, just really simple. And yeah, so the feet is made of this Technic piece, which I'm not sure what it's called, but you know, you can also move it around, can make it a different pose. And you know, it's cool, I guess, that it's on ball joint, you can move it around. But yeah, it's not really stable if one leg is off the ground. But yeah, so the back, you can see it has this really weird like tail piece, which, you know, I mean, it's cool to get this piece, but it just looks weird. But yeah, so the head here, you can see you got two of these stickers with the like the all the armor stuff. And you know, you can move them around, they are all on clip pieces. And the middle part right here is actually a Groid body, battle Groid body. And yeah, you got these little ears right here. And you know, the middle part here, you can see you got this piece, which you can put on the lance. And you can just put it like that. And yeah, the other side, it has a little clip. And yeah, this thing can move around, so you know, you can turn the head around, I guess. But you know, you got this this piece right here, which allows Lance to you know, just put his hand over there to, you know, control the horse, I guess. But you know, like aside from that, that's really it for Lance's robot horse. So the second build here is the village build. So let's start off by taking a look at the top first. So you can see the top here, you got a platform here, which you know, you can stand a gargoyle on here. And yeah, so you got these projectiles, which is just a stone monster for the catapult, and you know, they are just like mini technic pieces, and you know, the catapult is just really simple, and just fire them pretty easily. You can just put on the projectile, and you know, you can just fire. So yeah, works pretty easily. And yeah, so looking at the rest of the build, you can see it's this whole thing is supported by both of these technic pieces, and you know, it looks nice, I guess, but you know, so the sides here, and see, you got these lightning pieces, which I'm not sure what they are for, but you know, like, I believe it's for some sort of effect, you know, when Grimrock is released, you know, they can both of these pieces can just drop down to make it more like cool, I guess. I'm not quite sure, but yeah, so on the sides here, you can see you got these lightning pieces, which this gargoyle can use as a weapon, and they are on both sides as well. And yeah, so here is a little spot for Grimrock, and yeah, it's pretty like not so like not so well connected. And you know, because it's connected by only both of these studs. And yeah, so you can see this piece just cropped off, but you know, it's just a piece holding the whole thing in the middle. And yeah, it's just really like not connected well. And yeah, so the back here, you can see you got the forbidden power. So you know, I forgot what the forbidden power name is. I believe it's like malicious melting or something, but you know, you can just take it off, you know, and you know, put it on Lance, I guess, when he retrieves it. But you know, you can just put it right here, or you can just take away the whole stand because it's just on this simple brick piece. And yeah, so I guess like that's pretty much it for this village build. So yeah, that's it for all of the builds. So overall conclusion of this set, so how do I think of it? Well, the figures Lance is you know, it's okay, and you know, like, you can just get him in a cheaper set, but you know, he's okay. And yeah, the gargoyle, the wings is pretty cool, and Grimrock is a nice buildable figure. It's just that the head just looks a little bit weird. So the builds, Lance's robot horse is it's okay. It's nice to get another vehicle for Lance, but you know, it just doesn't look so great. But you know, it's still okay. So the village build, it just kind of sucks. Like, really, it just isn't a great build. Like, the place to hold Grimrock is just not so, just doesn't do its job. Like, you know, it just sucks. So you know, like, everything just falls apart. And you know, this lightning piece supposed to like just stay up, but it just keeps falling off. But you know, I guess you can see that as a play feature. But yeah, the forbidden power is cool. The catapult is nice, but aside from all those stuff, like, the build just doesn't look so great. But you know, nonetheless, it's still pretty cool to get a set. But yeah, the price of it is just doesn't seem so great for a set. I mean, I think Grimrock is the reason why the set is so expensive. But you know, I got this because I got the 50% off from Toys R Us. Like, yeah, that's the only reason why I got this set. So you know, but yeah, so overall conclusion, I do not recommend you getting this set. So yeah, buying for this down in the description box below, along with all my social media pages down in the description. So if you are interested in my content, make sure to subscribe right here and watch all my other videos right here. So yeah, that's it for the video. Thanks for watching.